Dude, this is bad, man. This is really bad. Oh, this song is fucking good. Jesus Christ, is this motherfucker good. Sorry, everybody's deaf now. Hold on. Now do it.
The following program is intended for mature audiences.
You know, I don't know what your problem is, dude. We used to work so well together. Now, you don't want to do anything right for me.
Welcome.
I don't get it, man. I don't get it at all.
What are you selling?
Podcast is out. I'm working on episode 20, dude. I'm bringing this up because I want to throw a clip into the podcast, but we'll get there. Hold on. Now check this out, dude. Hold on, where did it go? There's a lot of singles on this album, dude. But I don't know if some of the songs that I really enjoy are, like, popular. Do people know them? Like this one. Like, bro, this is the fire right here, dude. I put it in language you can understand. This song is serious. You learn some shit, dude. For the nasty ladies out there, dude. You wonder why they call you bitch. Look here, Miss Stang, hate to salt your game, but choose a money younger woman and you need to change. In the locker room, all I was laugh. High fives, cause another nigga played your ass. Ugh, Jesus Christ. I'm gonna have to explore this album for those of you that don't know. Now, this is, I know it's early, super early. And I'm flirting with the idea of giving you that other video that I made yesterday. Poor motherfuckers. The sons of bitches had no chance, dude. None at all, whatsoever.
In particular, while medical examiners are required to be doctors, coroners are usually not medically trained at all. In fact, in Georgia, out of 154 coroners, only one is a physician, while the others include grocers, farmers, handymen, and hairdressers, which is a little bit weird. I mean,
dude, did you have any idea that a coroner didn't have to be a doctor? I didn't know that. I don't know the name of the song, but there's a fucking rap song where the lyrics are, you know, that he does something so foul to a body that it makes the coroner puke. I don't remember the name of the song, and it's a horrible visual, but now this fact takes the power away from that statement, right? Because if the coroner was a doctor in their spare time, that would mean they've seen some shit, which would make it a lot harder for them to be shaken by anything that they've ever seen. But if it's a regular guy, like a hairdresser, come on, bro. That guy sees split ends and his fucking whole day is ruined, dude. It's not good news at all. Now, there's a reason why I'm bringing this up.
Yeah!
Because my state is mentioned in here, and I knew nothing about this, which is going to lead me down to my own little investigation to try to find out what the fuck is going on.
No disrespect to hairdressers, but some have been. How the hell grocers and elect
anatomical training?
You cannot be an official. You also come the on, county man. Sheriff. County
Where is it at? California? Where is my state at, dude?
Don't have any suggestion of deca.
I should have wrote down the timestamps. Is what I should have did.
No way.
Oh my god. Yeah, dude, that fucking guy.
Where staff posed for photos with a severed head.
Staff posed for photos with a severed head. You know what I'd like to do to that guy right there? This motherfucker right here. I like to punch him in his fucking face. The fuck is the matter with you, man?
Was a medical examiner's office. The guy who took the brain home for his kids to play with, he was and still is a medical examiner. And that's not even mentioning the medical examiner at the center of the most fantastic 2020 interview of all time.
I'll let you guys see this.
The other charge is that your dog ate one of the bodies.
Look at his face, dude.
And then he also ate a kidney. Is that true?
Look at his face, dude.
Dr. Hahn.
Bro. He's looking at this fucking interviewer. I swear to God, he's thinking two things.
Fucking bullshit!
Exactly.
You don't want to respond. You can deny this.
If I wish that the soundboard works, I would like to play the Exorcist piano over this guy's face. I mean, we could drop a piano in his face. That'd be cool, too.
If it's not true. It's never happened to me in an ABC News interview.
Oh, no.
Or since. But Charles Harlan fell completely silent. He didn't.
This, what a fucking asshole, right? What a fucking asshole. Oh, man, come on, dude. Where did it go? This is really bad of me to do this. I'm a mess right now. Wait, there he is. I think that's my guy that I'm looking for. Hold on.
Certified forensic pathologists running these offices and performing autopsies. But that is not going to happen anytime soon.
Talk, Jimmy John.
There's a dire shortage of those. In fact, there are only 500 of them currently practicing in the whole United States.
Shit. Dude, what is happening to us when we all die? And I know this is not something that you guys like to think about. A lot of people get freaked out at the idea. Me, personally, I don't like to dwell on it, but the last few days I've had anxiety because I've really been thinking about it a lot, dude. Just my choices in life, the things that I've done that I wish I could take back, and I can't. Not like I've killed anybody, but, you know, dumb shit. Smoking cigars and fucking all that nonsense.
Which is less than half the recommended number. And when you combine this staffing shortage with the current opioid crisis causing an increase in bodies that need examining, you get a system that is pushed well past.
This is my guy right here.
In New Jersey a few years back,
yeah, here we go.
Their acting state medical examiner resigned in frustration, citing staff shortages as one of the key reasons.
I felt as I walked in the door, they didn't have enough personnel to handle the load. You don't want to come to a family and say, I'm sorry, ma'am. I'm sorry, Mrs. Smith. We couldn't do the investigation that we wanted because we didn't have the resources.
That's crazy.
Right. He wanted to serve people well, but he couldn't. And things have frankly not got much better in New Jersey since.
No, they haven't. This place sucks. This is probably one of the only states in the entire country where they fuck us every chance they get for money, and they put none of it back into the state, dude. It's fucking bananas.
For the time being, if you do find yourself dying there, please write down whatever is killing you on a post-it note and stick it to your chest. You'd really be doing their overstretched investigators a solid. Thanks.
That's my favorite, dude. I love that he just did that, because that was one of the only good jokes in this episode. Oh. And I mean, I like it better. I like it better when John Oliver focuses on stuff like this, because this is why I started watching his show. To learn things about shit that I would never have known before. But I wanted to show you guys that, because that's fucking crazy to me. Matter of fact, Yeah, I won't look it up now because that it wouldn't make for good content, I don't think. But I wrote down the dude's name, so I'll check it out. I'm deciding whether or not I should put that other video out today. I feel like I have to because I did one after the other. And let me show you what I'm talking about. This one. No, I mean, come on. Come on, bro. I should do it, right? I should do it. I'll put this one out and I'll put that one out. Because let's be honest, a lot of people are not going to click on this video simply because of what it's about. A lot of people aren't going to. So I'll give you an alternative, right? And I'm not going to harp on this on the podcast, but I want to do a little bit of research and see if it's worth bringing up. In the meantime, check out the other episodes. Anchor, Spotify, iTunes. 19 episodes out all together. Laughing at Birds. I'll put the other one out. I'll do it right now. Okay. But it will make sense. You'll see this after that one. Because that one's already done. So I can put it right now. Instead of... You get what I'm saying. I need a button. I need a button that helps me just hang this shit up quickly.
Sweet Jesus.
Close enough.